Good morning, this is Christina Long and this is The Science 411. Today's video is focused exclusively on increasing rate of solvation in solutions. Now the topic is really a review of a minor piece of the notes from last week on your solution notes. But in order to get into this, there are some terms that you need to make sure that you understand. The term solvation really is just a fancy term for dissolving. Okay, so solvation is just a fancier sounding term for dissolving. Now a solution, yeah, it can be used as just a descriptive term, but in this case what we're looking at is solution is actually always made of a solvent plus a solute. And if you remember back from those notes, the solvent does the dissolving, and then the solute gets dissolved. Okay. All right. So there are several ways to increase solvation. The first one is to crush it. Basically, you're trying to make the particle smaller to increase surface area. The whole point of solvation is trying to get the particles of solvent to run into the particles of solute. And so you're trying to increase that surface area or to increase the rate it happens or whatever. But in this case, one way to increase the ability of solute-solvent to run into each other is to crush it and to increase the surface area. So you can see in that larger particle, the yellow represents the surface area. And when that piece dissolves, it's just going to dissolve layer by layer like a jawbreaker. But if you crush it and go into little tiny pieces, then it's going to dissolve much faster, just like if you were able to break a jawbreaker into smaller pieces, it's going to dissolve a lot easier. The second way to increase solvation is to stir it. Now the fancy term is called agitation. So in agitation, this essentially just speeds up how fast the solvent touches the solute. Because again, you're trying to get those to run into each other because the solvent will dissolve the solute. So if you stir it, it's going to speed up that process. The third way to increase solvation is to change the temperature. And you've got two scenarios here. The first scenario, which is the most common, is that hot liquids can hold more solid and liquid solutes. Basically, the molecules spread out, so they have more space to hold the solid or the liquid. The thing is, though, is this is not the case for gases. It's in fact the exact opposite. Cold liquids can hold more gas, and you've seen examples of that with a soda that you drink. If you go and buy a soda from the machine, it's going to be fairly cold. And when you open it and start drinking it, it's going to have a good bit of carbonation. The warmer that drink gets, the less carbonated it becomes. And it's because the gas gains more energy as it warms up, and it actually escapes from the can. Because remember, gases are states of matter that have a lot of energy and they want to be free. They do not want to be bound up. They want to spread out and move around. And so the warmer those gases become, well, the more it's going to do that. The fourth and final main way to increase solvation is to change pressure. Now this is only for gases. And the reason is that gases are the only state of matter that can be compressed. You can't compress a solid and you can't compress a liquid, but you can for a gas. So if you increase pressure forces, increasing pressure forces more gas into a solution. Basically, it's just going to push it in there. And this is one of the reasons that why when sodas fizz when you open them, because they were bottled really cold and they increased the pressure and they forced carbon dioxide gas into the soda. Well, when you go to open it, number one, you are releasing some of that pressure so the gas escapes. And in most cases, you're going to open it and it's going to be warmer than when it was bottled. So it's going to release gas there as well. If you don't believe me, get a soda. Open it up. Don't shake it, please. Open it up. And after you've had a couple of sips, listen to the opening. And you'll actually hear the gas escaping. So these are the four main ways that you can increase solvation of a solution. So, again, you may want to go back and look at your solutions video. It's towards the end if you want a little more help on this. But it's mainly just terminology and remembering some common sense stuff that you already know. I hope this was helpful for you. I hope you guys are doing well. I do miss you. Remember to make good choices and clean your room. Until next time, bye.